Hvala, Zmago, i dobar dan svima. Oh, I'm really glad to be here with you in Ljubljana. Vesel sem, da sem lahko z vami tukaj v Ljubljani. It's my first time in Ljubljana on Sabbath. To je prvi moj obisk v Ljubljani v soboto. I have preached in Maribor. Pridigal sem že v Mariboru. I preach in Celje, but not on Sabbath. Tudi v Celju, ampak ne v soboto. But this is my first time with you, so I'm glad to see you and be with you. Teda, danes sem prvi z vami in vesel sem, da je temu tako. And it's very interesting for me to listen to Slovenian language.
In zelo zanimivo mi je tudi poslušati slovenski jezik.
Yes. Zmago asked me to talk about the Adventist identity.
Prosili smo ga, da spregovori o adventistični identiteti.
And the question is, what kind of church we want to be?
In vprašanje je seveda, kakšna cerkev želimo biti?
Here in Ljubljana, what kind of church do you want to be?
Torej, tukaj v Ljubljani, kakšna cerkev želite biti?
What kind of church should we be?
Kakšna cerkev bi naj bili?
And the question is not what I think or you think.
In vprašanje seveda ni, kaj mislim jaz ali kaj mislite vi.
The question is, what kind of church are we supposed to be according to the Holy Scripture?
Vprašanje je, kakšna cerkev bi naj bili, glede na to, kar piše v Svetem pismu.
I don't know if you sometimes have this experience.
Ne vem, ali imate kdaj to izkušnjo.
I have read the end of the Gospel of John 100 times, 1000 times.
100-krat, 1000-krat, mogoče sem prebral konec Janezovega evangelija.
And suddenly you read it, and something hits you for the first time.
In ko tako berete, vas nekaj zadene, in to prvič.
And so, this morning, I would want you to open the Gospel of John.
Zato bi danes zjutraj vas povabil, da odpremo skupaj Janeza evangelij.
And we are going to look at the last three stories of the Gospel of John.
In ogledali si bomo zadnje tri zgodbe v Janezovem evangeliju.
And we are not going to read them.
Ne bomo jih brali.
To save time.
Da prihranimo tudi nekaj časa.
And the lady in charge of youth read beautifully the first story for us.
In Pia je že prebrala prvo zgodbo za nas.
So the first story,
prva zgodba,
after Jesus was resurrected,
po Jezusovem vstajenju,
and then Jesus appears to Mary Magdalene,
Jezus se prikaže Mariji Magdaleni,
and then comes the story how Jesus appears to the disciples.
In potem pride zgodba, kako se Jezus prikaže učencem.
After that he appears to Thomas,
potem se prikaže Tomažu,
and then Jesus appears to Peter.
In potem Petru.
And here's the question.
In vprašanje.
Why did John choose these three stories to end his gospel?
Zakaj Janez izbral te tri zgodbe, da bi z njimi zaključil svoj evangelij?
Were there no other people that Jesus could appear to?
Ali ni bilo drugih ljudi, ki bi se jim Jezus lahko razodel?
That would give a greater credibility to his gospel.
Ki bi Janezovemu evangeliju dali večjo kredibilnost.
For example, Apostle Paul in 1 Corinthians 15,
apostol Pavel v 1. Korinčanom 15,
he says there are about 500 people who saw Jesus resurrected.
Pravi, da je bilo okrog 500 ljudi, ki so videli vstalega Kristusa.
Why John did not end his gospel saying,
zakaj Janez ne zaključi svojega evangelija z besedami?
And if you want to know that Jesus truly was resurrected,
če želite vedeti, da Jezus res vstal od mrtvih,
go to that and that address,
pojdite na ta in ta naslov,
talk to those people,
govorite s temi ljudmi,
they met him live after he was dead.
Ti so ga videli živega, potem ko je bil mrtev.
Here is your proof of the resurrection.
Tukaj je vaš dokaz za vstajenje.
Now, of course, that would be good in the first century.
A seveda bi to bilo zelo dobro v prvem stoletju.
Not for you and me, living in 21st.
Ne pa za vas in zame, ki živimo v 21. stoletju.
So why John ended his gospel this way?
Zakaj Janez zaključuje svoj evangelij torej na ta način?
And I would like to humbly submit to you,
ponižno bi vam rad predlagal,
that the way he ends his gospel,
da je način, kako Janez zaključuje svoj evangelij,
John is giving us a picture of community that Jesus will have on this planet.
Takšen, da nam Janez predstavi sliko skupnosti, ki jo bo Jezus imel na tem planetu.
The greatest proof of resurrection,
največji dokaz za vstajenje,
is the type of community, the type of church Jesus will have on this planet.
Je vrsta skupnosti, vrsta cerkve, ki jo bo Jezus imel na tem planetu.
In a free universe,
v svobodnem vesolju,
you can always find a counter argument against any proof of resurrection.
Lahko namreč vedno najdete protiargument za vsak dokaz o vstajenju.
But if you have a group of believers,
teda, če imate skupino vernikov,
who are different than everybody else,
ki so drugačni kot vsi ostali,
what kind of argument do you want to use against that?
Kakšen argument bi želeli uporabiti proti tem?
And so, let's notice,
zato zapazimo te tri zgodbe.
And let's start in verse 19 to 21.
Torej, začnemo v 19. vrstici 20. poglavja do 21. vrstice. Pod noč tistega dne, prvega v tednu, ko so bila tam, kjer so se učenci zadrževali, vrata iz strahu pred ljudi zaklenjena, je prišel Jezus, stopil med nje in jim rekel, mir vam bodi. In ko je to rekel, jim je pokazal roke in stran. Učenci so se razveselili, ko so videli gospoda. Tedaj mi je Jezus spet rekel, mir vam bodi. Kakor je oče mene poslal, tudi jaz vas pošiljam.
It's a very important story.
Zelo pomembna zgodba.
Jesus comes to meet his disciples.
Jezus pride, da bi se srečal z učenci.
The last time he saw them and they saw him,
ko jih je zadnjič videl in ko so oni zadnjič videli njega,
they ran away.
So ti pobegnili.
In the greatest difficulty, the most difficult circumstances of his life,
v najbolj težavnih okoliščinah njegovega življenja,
they forsake him.
So ga zapustili.
This is the first time he sees them after the resurrection.
In to je zdaj prvič, ko jih vidi po vstajenju.
And you know what he says to them?
In veste, kaj jim pravi?
Now I can see what kind of fair weather friends you are.
Zdaj lahko vidim, kakšni oportunistični prijatelji ste.
Good translation. Well done. No.
Ne.
That's not what he said to them.
Ne, Jezus ne reče tega.
You know what he said to them?
Veste, kaj mi reče?
Peace to you.
Mir vam bodi.
I am not angry with you.
Ja se ne jezim na vas.
I am not upset with you.
Nisem vznemirjen.
Everything is okay.
Vse je okay.
I love you.
Imam vas rad.
And you see what it says? It said it so nicely. Učenci se razveselili, kao videli gospoda. And the disciples were glad to see Jesus.
Učenci so se razveselili, ko so videli Jezusa.
Why?
Zakaj?
They didn't expect this treatment.
Niso pričakovali, da bo z njimi ravnal tako.
They failed Jesus.
Jezusa so razočarali.
But they received God's grace.
Ampak dobili so Božjo milost.
And once again, Jesus is going to say to them,
in Jezus jim še enkrat reče,
mir vam bodi. And then he adds,
in potem doda,
kakor je Oče mene poslal, tudi ja vas pošlijam. As a father sent me, I am sending you down.
Kakor je Oče mene poslal, jaz zdaj vas pošiljam.
Why?
Zakaj?
The treatment you have received from me,
to, kako sem jaz ravnal z vami,
you extend to other now.
Je način, kako vi ravnajte z drugim.
And what is the first lesson you and I are supposed to learn?
In kaj prvi nauk, ki ga bi naj sprejeli?
The power of Christ's community is in a personal encounter with Jesus.
Moč Kristusove skupnosti je v osebnem srečanju z Jezusom.
That the disciples meet with Jesus,
to, da se učenci srečajo z Jezusom,
who extends to them acceptance, forgiveness and peace.
Ki jim ponudi sprejemanje, odpuščanje in mir.
If you want to have a Christian community,
če želite imeti krščansko skupnost,
you have to have a community of faith.
Morate imeti skupnost vere.
And if you want to welcome people into a community of faith,
in če želite sprejemati ljudi v skupnost vere,
first you have to have a community of faith.
Morate najprej to skupnost vere imeti.
People who believe in Jesus.
Ljudje, ki verujejo v Jezusa.
People who had this experience.
Ljudje, ki so imeli to izkušnjo.
Of acceptance, forgiveness,
sprejemanja, odpuščanja.
That somebody was nicer to them,
da je nekdo bil do njih ljubeznivejši,
than they were to him.
Kot so bili oni do njega.
Listen to this.
Poslušajte to.
The power of Christian church,
Moč krščanske cerkve.
Is not how nice people are.
Ni v tem, kako prijazni so ljudje.
How cool is the music?
Kako dobra je glasba.
How beautiful is the building?
Kako čudovita je stavba.
But it's in people who encountered Jesus.
Ampak je v ljudeh, ki so se srečali z Jezusom.
Who have been forgiven,
ljudeh, ki jim je bilo odpuščeno,
who have experienced God's grace,
ki so doživeli Božjo milost,
and say, if God was so nice to me, I'm going to be nice to you.
In ki pravijo, če Bog bil tako ljubeznil do mene, bom jaz do tebe.
That's the first story of the last three stories of the
To je prva od zadnjih treh zgodb v Janezovem evangeliju.
If you want to have a community of faith,
če želite skupnost vere,
you need to have believers who have met Jesus.
Potrebujete vernike, ki so se srečali z Jezusom.
Experienced his grace.
In izkusili njegovo milost.
In spite of their failures,
kljub svojim pomanjkljivosti,
running away, forsaking him,
svojemu bežanju, zapuščanju Jezusa.
We are all on the same level.
Smo vsi na isti stopni.
No attitude, I am better than you.
Ni miselnost, jaz sem boljši kot ti.
Just acceptance and peace.
Samo sprejemanje in mir.
And when people meet Jesus like this, the disciples were razveselili se.
In ko se ljudje srečajo z ljudmi na ta način, seveda potem se učenci razveselijo.
And if people in Ljubljana,
če se ljudje v Ljubljani
come to this place,
pridejo na ta prostor
and find people,
in najdejo ljudi,
who in their life met Jesus Christ,
ki so v svojem življenju srečali Jezusa Kristusa,
they truly will be rejoicing.
Se bodo v resnici razveselili.
Yeah. Definitely se bodo razveselili.
Zagotovo bo tako.
Yeah. Okay, is that all?
Je to vse?
No, there is another story.
Ne, je še druga zgodba.
And then from verses 24,
od 24. Vrstice,
hey, you can start reading.
Tomaža, enega izmed dvanajsterih, ki se je imenoval Dvojček, pa ni bilo med njimi, ko je prišel Jezus. Drugi učenci so mu torej pripovedovali: Gospoda smo videli. On pa jim je rekel: Če ne vidim na njegovih rokah rane od žebljev in ne vtaknem prsta v rane od žebljev in ne položim roke v njegovo stran, nikakor ne bom veroval.
Now, the last time I have seen some of you,
ko sem zadnjič videl nekatere med vami,
was in September 2012,
je to bilo septembra 2012,
when we had the Congress of Adriatic Union in Maruševcu.
Ko je bil kongres Jadranske unije v Maruševcu,
and then I traveled on the bus with you.
In jaz sem z avtobusom potem potoval z vami nazaj do Ljubljane.
Now, if you have been to a great meeting, great spiritual experience,
če ste udeleženci nekega velikega, veličastnega srečanja, duhovnega srečanja,
and then you try to explain to someone who was not there,
in potem poskušate nekomu, ki ni bil tam, pojasniti,
what was that experience? What did you experience?
Kakšna je bila ta izkušnja? Kaj ste doživeli?
You know how difficult that is.
Veste, kako težko je to.
How do you combine the information,
kako to informacijo,
emotion,
čustvo,
and the spiritual encounter that you had.
In to duhovno srečanje združite v eno.
It's very difficult to explain to someone who was not there.
Težko je pojasniti nekomu, ki ni bil tam.
The depth of the experience that you personally had.
Globino izkušnje, ki ste jo vi osebno doživeli.
And that's what we are reading in the next story.
In to beremo v tej naslednji zgodbi.
The disciples met with Jesus.
Učenci so se srečali z Jezusom.
But Thomas was not there.
Ampak Tomaža ni bilo tam.
And the next time they meet,
in ko so se srečali, zbrali naslednjič,
Thomas is there.
Je Tomaž tam.
And the disciples say, we have met Jesus.
In učenci pravijo, videli smo Jezusa.
Can you imagine what an experience that was for us?
Si lahko zamisliš, kakšna izkušnja je bila to za nas?
But Thomas is not accepting their explanation.
Ampak Tomaž ne sprejema njihove razlage.
Yes, it's nice for you guys to have that experience.
Lepo, da ste imeli to izkušnjo, fantje.
But it's not my experience.
Ampak to ni moja izkušnja.
I am glad for you.
Vesel sem za vas.
But that's not my experience.
Ampak to ni moje doživetje.
What do you do?
Kaj naredite?
How do you treat people?
Kako ravnate z ljudmi?
And you know what's interesting?
In veste, kaj je zanimivo?
8th day, verse 26.
V 26. vrstici, Čez 8 dni so bili njegovi učenci spet notri in Tomaž z njimi. Jezus je prišel pri zaprtih vratih, stopil mednje in jim rekel: "Mir vam bodi."
Have you heard those words before?
Ste že slišali te besede?
Peace be with you.
Mir vam bodi.
But you know what's interesting?
Ampak veste, kaj je
zanimivo?
8 dni pozneje.
His disciples were together.
So bili učenci skupaj.
And Thomas was with them.
In Tomaž je bil z njimi.
And Thomas is with them.
Tomaž je z njimi.
Thomas surrounds himself with his friends. Surrounds himself with his friends.
Tomaž je obdan z njegovimi prijatelji.
And his friends, disciples, don't give up on him.
In njegovi prijatelji, učenci, se mu ne odpovedo, ne odneha.
Just because he sees things differently.
Ker vidi stvari drugače.
Even though Thomas did not believe,
čeprav Tomaž ni veroval,
the disciples resisted the temptation to purge this doubter from their midst.
So se učenci uprli skušnjavi, da bi izrinili tega dvomljivca iz svoje srede.
On the contrary, they are all together.
Prav nasprotno, vsi skupaj so.
Thomas, unbeliever,
Tomaž, neverni,
and the disciples who met Jesus.
In učenci, ki so srečali Jezusa.
And they provide the context in which Thomas can discover what he believes.
In oni postavljajo pravzaprav okoliščine, v katerih Tomaž lahko odkrije, kaj veruje.
He can figure out what he believes about Jesus.
Okoliščine, v katerih lahko dojame svojo vero.
And then potem, meets Jesus in that community.
In potem se v tej skupnosti sreča z Jezusom.
So here's the second lesson.
Tukaj je drugi nauk.
The purpose of Christ community,
namen Kristusove skupnosti,
is to provide a safe place for people to meet Jesus.
Je ponuditi ljudem varen prostor, kjer lahko srečajo Jezusa.
Remember the first point?
Se spomnite prvega nauka?
And remember, I'm a teacher, you're supposed to learn
something. In ne pozabite, jaz sem učitelj, zato se morate nekaj naučiti.
The first lesson is,
prvi nauk je,
the power of Christ community,
moč Kristusove skupnosti,
is in encounter with Jesus.
Je v srečanju z Jezusom.
But the purpose of the community.
Toda namen skupnosti.
So now when we have met Jesus,
torej zdaj, ko smo srečali Jezusa,
why are we here?
Zakaj smo tukaj?
To provide a safe place for other people to meet Jesus.
Da ponudimo varen prostor drugim ljudem, da srečajo Jezusa.
This is a place where Thomas can express his doubts.
To je prostor, kjer Tomaž lahko izrazi svoje dvome.
Now, safe place does not necessarily mean only comfortable.
Varen prostor ne pomeni nujno udoben.
Thomas is challenged with the truth.
Tomaž je pred izzivom, da da spozna resnico.
We see differently than you do.
Mi vidimo drugače kot ti.
But he is free to say, but guys, I don't agree with you.
In Tomaž ima svobodo reči, ampak jaz se ne strinjam z vami.
I am glad for your experience, but it's not my experience.
Vesel sem za vašo izkušnjo, ampak to ni moja izkušnja.
We are the best as a community of believers,
kot skupnost verujočih,
when we provide a safe place for people to express what they believe.
Smo najboljša možna skupnost, ko nudimo ta varen prostor ljudem, da lahko veruje.
Safe place means that people are welcome and accepted.
In ta varen prostor pomeni, da so ljudje dobrodošli in sprejeti
the way they are.
Takšni kot so.
We are not only going to welcome them, accept them once they are like us.
Ne bomo jih sprejeli z dobrodošlico takrat, ko bodo takšni kot smo mi.
If you do, you teach people to pretend.
Če to delate, potem učite ljudi, da se pretvarjajo.
But we don't want to support that as Christians.
Toda kot kristjani tega ne podpiramo.
The ultimate purpose and reason for existence is to help other people to meet Jesus.
Končni namen obstoja cerkve, torej pomagati ljudem, da srečajo Jezusa.
The disciples say, we have met Jesus.
Učenci so rekli, mi smo srečali Jezusa.
They try to convince him what convinced them.
Poskuša jo prepričati Tomaža s tem, kar je prepričalo njih.
But still Thomas is not convinced.
Ampak Tomaž še vedno ni prepričan.
He needs his own experience.
Tomaž potrebuje svojo izkušnjo.
The test of our community,
preizkus naše skupnosti,
is how we treat those who are different than, who believe differently than we do.
Je kako ravnamo s tistimi, ki verujejo drugače kot mi.
We function best as a community of faith.
Kot skupnost vere delujemo na najboljši možen način,
when we provide a safe place for people,
ko nudimo varen prostor ljudem,
to find out what they believe about Jesus.
Da ugotovijo, kaj verujejo o Jezusu.
We are best as a community.
Najboljši smo kot skupnost takrat,
when we provide a safe place,
ko nudimo varen prostor,
for people to be, to deal with the most important questions they have.
Ljudem, da se ukvarjajo z najpomembnejšimi vprašanji.
And let me tell you this.
In naj vam povem,
there are people who are watching how you are going to treat unbeliever Thomas.
In so ljudje, ki gledajo, kako boste ravnali z dvomljivim Tomažem.
For every unbeliever Thomas who dares to come to you,
za vsakega nevernega Tomaža, ki pride k vam,
and says, guys, but I see differently.
In pravi, ja, ampak jaz vidim stvari drugače.
There are 20 out there,
jih je 20 tam zune,
who are watching, how are you going to treat this one?
Ki gledajo, kako boste ravnali s tem meni.
Can I come to you?
Lahko pridem k vam?
Or are you going to condemn me or purge me out?
Ali me boste obsodili in me izgnali?
So, here is the first lesson, remember?
Prvi nauk, se spomnite?
The power of Christ's community is in personal encounter with Jesus.
Moč Kristusove skupnosti je v osebnem srečanju z Jezusom.
The story of the disciples meeting with Jesus.
Zgodba učencev, ki se srečajo z Jezusom.
The second lesson,
drugi nauk,
Jesus meeting with Tomas.
Jezus se sreča s Tomažem.
The purpose of community is to provide a safe place to ask questions about Jesus.
Namen skupnosti je ponuditi varen prostor, kjer lahko ljudje postavljajo vprašanja o Jezusu.
If you say, oh, but you can't even talk like that here.
A če rečete, oh, se ne moreš govoriti tako.
You can be sure Thomas is not going to keep coming back.
Potem ste lahko prepričani, da Tomaš ne bo več prihajal sem.
And if he does not meet Jesus here,
in če ne sreča Jezusa tukaj,
where is he going to meet?
Kje ga bo srečal?
We exist to provide a safe place for people who believe differently than us.
Obstajamo zato, da ponudimo varen prostor za ljudi, ki verjamejo drugače kot mi.
To work through their doubts, through their questions, da. Through their understanding.
Predelajo svoje dvome, svoje vprašanja in pridejo do razumevanja.
When I went to the elementary school,
ko sem hodil v osnovno šolo,
I had a teacher who said,
sem imel učitelja, ki je rekel,
nobody fell from heaven wise.
Nihče ni padel iz nebes pametno.
Only stupid where we came to this planet.
Samo neumni smo prišli na ta planet.
You and I did not come to this understanding overnight.
Mi, vi in jaz, nismo prišli do tega razumevanja čez noč.
It took us years, decades, to be where we are in our understanding, in our spiritual walk.
Leta, morda desetletja je bilo potrebno za to, da smo prišli do svojega razumevanja, do točke, kjer smo v svoji duhovni rasti.
But how often we have very little patience with those who see things differently than we do.
Toda, kako pogosto imamo tako zelo malo potrpežljivosti z ljudmi, ki vidijo stvari drugače kot mi.
All right. Let's go to the third story.
Gremo v tretjo zgodbo.
Actually, do you know that John finished his gospel in chapter 20?
Ali veste, da Janez končal svoj evangelij v 20. poglavju?
And he said,
in je rekel,
this is in verse 30.
V 30. vrsti.
Jesus provided many more signs.
Jezus je opričal svojih učencev, storil še veliko drugih znamen,
that are not written in this book.
Ki niso zapisane v tej knjigi.
And if you wanted to write all them down, all the,
če bi hoteli vse napisati,
all the libraries of the world would not contain the books.
Vsega tega ne bi mogli dati v vse knjižnice tega sveta.
But what is written so that you believe that Jesus is the Messiah.
Ampak to, kar je napisano zato, da bi vi verovali, da je Jezus Mesija.
So that you come to believe that Jesus is the Messiah.
Da bi vi verovali, torej začeli, da bi s tem, da verujete.
Yeah. And that you continue to believe that he is God's son.
Da bi nadaljevali torej svojo vero, da je Božji sin.
Yeah. In Greek is very clear. It's so that you come to believe and then you continue to believe.
Aha, v grščini je zelo jasno, torej da bi začeli verovati in da nadaljujete verovati potem.
And that's the end of the gospel.
In to je konec evangelija.
And then later he adds another story.
In potem poznaje doda še eno zgodbo.
And John explains in verse in chapter 21,
in v 21. poglavju Janez pojasnjuje,
that there was a rumor,
Da so bile govorice,
that verse 23,
23-та vrstica,
that John is not going to die,
da Janes ne bo umrl,
but people are watching his heartbeat,
ampak ljudje so opazovali njegov srčni utrip.
If John dies, then Jesus is not going to come back.
Če Janes umre, Jezus torej ne bo prišel nazaj.
Then his promise is not valid.
Njegova obljuba ne drži, torej če bo Janes umrl.
So John needs to write his story.
Zato Janes napiše zgodbo.
To explain, actually Jesus never said that John is never going to die.
Kateri pojasni tudi to, da Jezus nikoli ni rekel, da Janes ne bo umrl.
This is what the story was all about.
Ampak o tem je šla ta zgodba in je napisala.
The story was about Peter and about John.
Zgodba je o Petru, ne o Janes.
And so comes the third story and the last story of the Gospel of
John. In tako pridemo do te tretje in zadnje zgodbe v Janezovem evangeliju.
And so let's really start reading chapter 21, verse 1.
21. poglavje, prva vrsta. Potem se Jezus spet razodel učencem pri Tiberijskem jezeru. Razodel pa se je takole. Simon Peter, Tomaš, ki se imenuje Dvojček, Natanael iz Galilejske Kane, Zabedejeva sinova in dva druga izmed njegovih učencev so bili skupaj.
And verse 3.
Simon Peter jim je rekel, ribe grem lovit. Dejali so mu, tudi mi gremo s teboj. Odšli so in stopili v čoln, to da tisto noč niso nič ujeli.
These are some of the saddest words in the Gospels.
To so ene od najbolj žalostnih besed v evangelijih.
Peter said,
Peter pravi,
I am going fishing.
Grem lovit ribe.
Do you understand what's going on?
Ali veste, kaj se dogaja pravzaprav tukaj?
Peter says,
Peter pravi,
I didn't get this discipleship thing right.
Očitno mi ni uspela ta stvar za biti učenec.
You guys celebrate.
Vi proslavljate.
But it's not for me.
Ampak to ni za me.
I go back to fishing.
Grem nazaj k ribolovu.
And then comes some of the most encouraging things in the Gospels.
In potem pride ena od najbolj spodbudnih stvari v evangelijih.
And the rest of them replied, we are going with you.
In ostali pravijo, mi gremo s teboj.
Wow. Now there are commentators,
komentatori, nekateri,
who say that this is an expression of unbelief on the part of disciples.
Pravijo, da je to izraz nevere strani učencev.
But actually, when you think about it, it's not that thing.
Ampak, ko razmislite dobro o tem, pravzaprav ne gre za to.
They just say to Peter, we are community.
Petru preprosto pravijo, Peter, mi smo skupnost.
We are within, we are with you in this.
Mi smo skupaj s tabo v tem.
We are in it together.
Vsi smo v tem.
Peter says, I am going back to what I was good at.
Peter pravi, jaz grem nazaj k tistemu, v čemor sem bil dober.
I am going back to a familiar place.
Grem nazaj v znan kraj.
But the disciples say to him,
ampak učenci mu pravijo,
you are not going to be alone.
Ne boš sam.
We put arms around you, we are in it together.
Mi te bomo vili, mi bomo stavo v tem.
Now, you can be sure that this is not an expression of unbelief.
Prepričani ste lahko, da to ni izraz nevere.
Because Nathanael is not a fisherman.
Ker Nathanael ni ribič.
He is from a hill country.
Nathanael je iz goratega dela dežela.
Second,
drugič,
if disciples did not become unbelievers in face of Thomas's doubt,
če učenci niso postali neverniki v fazi Tomaževega dvoma,
why would they become unbelievers in facing Peter's resignation?
Zakaj bi zdaj postali neverniki, ko se soočajo s tem Petrovim obupom?
This is not the scene of apostasy, it's the scene of community.
To ni prizor odpada, ampak prizor skupnosti.
By the way, when they meet Jesus later,
mimo grede, ko kasneje srečajo Jezusa,
John says,
Janes pravi,
to Peter, Peter, this is Jesus, look
Peter,
the Lord.
Pravi, Peter, glej, to je Jezus, poglej gospoda.
He doesn't say to other disciples, guys, this is Jesus.
Ne pravi ostalim učencem, to je Jezus.
He tells that to Peter.
Ampak to reče Petru, v sedmi vrsti.
And then finally,
in potem, na koncu,
Jesus, Peter jumps off the boat.
Peter skoči s čolna.
And then Jesus has a discussion with Peter.
In potem ima Peter pogovor z Jezus, Jezus pogovor s Petrom.
Because Peter needs to be restored.
Ker Petra je treba obnoviti.
Jesus does not say any admonition to any other disciples.
Jezus ne daje posebnih besed in spodbud drugim učencem.
How come that you don't believe in me? Why did you go to Galilee?
Не говорим како то да не верувате во мене. Зошто не сте шли во Галилеја?
And so here is the story. Here is the third lesson.
И тука е трети наук.
The testimony of Christ's community is in reconciliation and redemption.
Причевање Христосове скупности е во справи и на одрешите.
Our greatest testimony is.
Наше највеќе причевање е.
How do we treat people who failed like Peter?
Како ровнамо с людьми ки со падли, кот е падел Петер?
Because if you are going through life long enough.
Кер че доволно долго живите.
You are going to gather few failings.
Босте набрали некај паце во својот живот.
Ernest Hemingway said it this way.
Ernest Hemingway рекол:
Life has a way of breaking down everybody.
Живење има начин како зломи усакога.
If you live long enough,
ќе живите доволно долго.
You are going to accumulate enough mistakes and failings in your life.
Босте накопичили во својот живот доволно напак и неуспехот.
Here is the question.
Прашање.
How is the community of Christ followers going to treat you when you fail?
Како во Христосова скупност равнала с вами кога се вам бо то згодило?
And you know what the disciples say?
Висте кај прави ученци?
They put the answer on Peter, we are in it together.
Дај роке округ Петра, Петер, ми смо става во тем.
Even though Peter was present and other appearances after the resurrection.
Чеправи Петер бил на зоч при осталих разодетих по устајењу.
He feels embarrassed.
Се чутио срамоченега.
He is lonely.
Осамленега.
Broken.
Зломленега.
Broken and ready to give up.
Ин приправленега однекаде.
But the disciples say, "We are going with you."
Апак ученци правија Петер, ми гремо сте во.
Karl Barth said.
Карл Барт е рекол.
The question that we need to ask the Christian community.
Прашање ки си го мораме заставлати кај христијанска скупност.
Is are we true witnesses?
Али смо прави приче?
And this is not just a question of what we are saying.
И тоа не е прашање тега кај говориме.
It has to do with our very existence.
Апак е повезано за нашим обстојам.
We are followers of Jesus when we accept those who fail.
Јесусови следилци смо ако спремамо тисте ки паде.
Why?
Закај?
Because Jesus accepted us.
Кер Јесус спреел нас.
Who failed him.
Ки смо га разочарали.
Our witness, our testimony, our story.
Наше причевање, наша згодба.
Is to model, to show the world the story of redemption.
Је показати свету згодба о справи на одрешитви.
Just as there are those who are watching how you treat unbelievers like Thomas.
Прато колку тоа тисти ки опазуваат како ровнате за неверники како е Томаш.
There are those out there.
Со тисти други луѓе туди.
Who are watching how you treat those who fail.
Ки опазуваат како ровнате со тистими ки доживио неуспех, ки паде.
People need to say.
Луѓе би морали речи.
Even if you have to be disfellowshipped.
Че туди те потребно исклучити.
The best place to be this fellowship is in Seventh-day Adventist Church.
Е најбојши простор кер се ти тоа козгоди во адвентистична црква.
They do it with white gloves.
Затоа кер се тоа нареди за белими рокавици.
How do you treat those who fail?
Како ровнате с тистими ки пада?
That's what shows whether we are followers of Jesus or not.
Тоа кажа али сме Исусови следилци или не.
And in spite of public failure of Peter.
И клуб јавному пацу ки го Петер доживел. Јавно неуспех.
Jesus deals with him publicly. Yes.
Јесус се одзове на тоа јавно.
But assuring him, I love you and I have a place for you.
Ампак му заготавља, имам те рад и имам простор за те.
All is not over.
Не е сега конец.
You still can do something for my sheep.
Ше видно лако наредиш некај за моја овца.
And because how Jesus treated Peter.
И заради тега како Јесус ровна с Петром
on the day of Pentecost,
на Бинкошни дан,
Peter can become blessing to 3000 people.
Петер постане благослов за 3000 луѓе.
Peter is a blessing to 3000 people.
Петер е благослов за 3000 луѓе.
Because the disciples say we are in it together.
Кога со ученци рекли Петер, ставо смо во тем.
And Jesus say, ah. We thought you are a better pope than that.
Ни се рекле, а мислели смо да се бојиш и папешкото.
The mission of Christ's community.
Посланство Христосове скупности.
Is to help people like Thomas.
Е помагати людям, като Томаш.
And Peter.
И Петър.
Those who have doubts.
Тистин, ки имаат двоме.
And those who fail.
И тистин, ки падат.
It was in the community context of community.
В контексту скупности.
That Thomas discovered what he believes about Jesus.
Томаш открие кай верує в Ісуса.
And Peter discovered what Jesus believed about him.
In Peter открие кай Ісус верява на.
Peter has discovered that even at his worst,
Peter
that he was the worst.
Петър открие да туди у тренутку кое најбол на тлех, најниже,
Jesus still loves him.
Кай Ісус ще видно люби.
Peter discovered that for Jesus he was worth restoring.
И Петър открие да е в Ісусових очах вреден обновен.
And because they are the followers of Jesus.
Кер со Ісусови следилци.
Peter is worth restoring for them too.
Е за них Петър рано тако вреден обновен.
Why are we here?
Закај смо ту в Любљани?
To help people like Thomas and Peter.
Да помагамо людям кот е Томаш и Петър.
We have questions, we have doubts, we have faith.
Ки маја двоме, прашања, ки се падат.
And if Jesus will have a disciples like that.
And ќе би Исус имел ученце, кот со ти.
Imagine what difference this community can make.
Си лако само представлямо какшно разлико би поменила такшна скупност.
Why did John end with these three stories?
Закај Јанес кончава Евангелие с теми треми згодбами?
Because the greatest proof of Christ's resurrection.
Кер е највеќи доказ за Христосово стаење.
Is when the church is a safe place.
То да е церква варен простор.
For people to find out what they believe about Jesus.
За луѓе да откријат кај веруваат во Исусу.
And to discover what Jesus believes about them.
И да откријат кај Исус верува и мисли о нив.
And when you have a community like that.
Кога имате такшна скупност.
Then even the doubts of Thomas or failures of Peter are not going to destroy.
Потем е туди Томажеви двоми и Петров падец не бодо уничи.
They just make you stronger.
Апак вас само укрепија.
The disciples were a community of faith that could take Thomas's doubt.
Ученци со били скупност вере кој лако спреела Томажеви двоми.
And Peter's failure.
И Петров неуспех и падец.
It just made them stronger.
Тој ги ле укрепило.
Do you know why John finished his gospel with the three stories?
Али висте закај Јанес кончал свој евангелие с треми згодбами?
Because the power of Christ community.
Кер е моќ Христосове скупности.
Is in personal encounter.
Посебним среќање.
The purpose.
Намен.
Is in being a safe place for those who have doubts and ask questions.
Бити варен крај за тисте кои имаат двоми и спрашуваат.
And the testimony is.
И причевање е.
To model redemption and reconciliation for those who fail.
Показати справа и надрешита.
And if God can help people like that.
И че Бог лако има люди, кот со ти.
When things will change in Slovenia.
Потем се бодо ствари у Словенија спремине.
Listen to what a historian said about an early church.
Послушайте кај нек згодовинар прави о први церкви.
What was holding the Christian community together was not a family tie.
То кое држало кршчанску скупност скупа не била дружинска вез.
Social or economic equality.
Дружбена или економска еднаквост.
They have been all roughly in the same income category.
Тоа е да си били вистен дружбеним разреду.
Or shared oppression or complaint.
Али па затирање кои се го делиле, али притожбе.
Or mutual attraction.
Али медсебојна привлачност.
The basis of Christian community was the divine call.
Темел кршчански скупност е бил Божји клиц.
Be the community for Thomas and Peter.
Бодите скупност за Томажа и Петра.
In society where you and I live.
Во дружбе кои ви и јас живиме.
People are chasing different experiences.
Се луѓе призадеваја доживети различни ствари.
But they have very few deep relationships.
Тоа има зело мало рез глобоки односи.
Douglas Copeland said in the Shampoo Planet.
Douglas Copeland в книги Планет Шампона прави.
People without lies hang out with people who don't have lies, and thus they form lies.
Ljudje brez življenj se družijo z drugimi ljudmi, ki nimajo življenj in tako tvorijo življenje.
Very good translation. Hvala. And Keith Miller in the book The Scent, you understand scent.
In Keith Miller v knjigi Von ljubezni,
he says the reason why the early Christian church was so successful,
razlog zakaj je bila prva krščanska cerkev tako uspešna,
was not because of the exemplary gifts,
niso bili njihovi darovi,
or because they preached palatable doctrine,
ali razumna doktrina,
but because they had found the secret to community.
Ampak to, da so našli skrivnost skupnosti.
And this community gave the scent of love,
in ta skupnost je dala von ljubezni,
where people would continually would say,
tam, kjer so ljudje neprestano govorili,
I don't have the slightest idea what these people are talking about, but whatever it is, I want to be part of that.
Nimam pojma, o čem govorijo te ljudje, ampak karkoli že to je, želim biti del tega.
In Acts 2:46,
v apostolskih delih 2:46,
it says,
pravi,
i vsi ljudje se jih imeli radi.
2:47, in vsi ljudje so jih imeli radi.
You know how message Eugene Peterson?
Kako besedilo, ki ga napisal Eugene Peterson v prevodu message, pravi?
And Eugene Peterson translates,
on to prevaja tako,
and people liked what they saw.
Ljudem je bilo všeč to, kar so videli.
What does it mean?
Kaj to pomeni?
I don't have the slightest idea what they are talking
about. Nimam pojma, o čem govorijo.
But I like what I see.
Ampak všeč mi je to, kar vidim.
I need that in my life.
To potrebujem v svojem življenju.
So, okay. Let me read this quotation from Bonhoeffer, it's beautiful.
Prebral bom ta citat od Bonhoefferja, čudovit.
When you become a Christian,
ko postanete kristjan,
you bring into Christian community a very clear idea what everybody else should be like.
Prinesete v krščansko skupnost zelo jasno idejo o tem, kakšni bi morali biti vsi drugi ljudje.
And now you try to convert everybody to your idea of Christianity.
In zdaj poskušate spreobrniti vsakega v svojo idejo krščanstva.
And Bonhoeffer says,
Bonhoeffer pa pravi,
but God in his grace speedily shatters these dreams.
Toda Bog v svoji milosti hitro razblini takšne sanje.
That you can convert all others to your model of Christianity.
Da lahko vi spreobrnete vse druge v svoj model krščanstva.
Because just as surely as God desires to lead us to knowledge of genuine Christian fellowship,
ker prav tako zanesljivo, kot nas Bog želi pripeljati do spoznanja pristnega krščanskega občestva,
we must be, he leads us to the overwhelmed disappointment, disillusion with others,
nas vodi do velikega razočaranja s drugimi ljudmi,
with Christians in general,
s kristjani na splošno,
and if we are fortunate, with
ourselves. In če imamo srečo, tudi razočaranja nad nami samimi.
Because God loves you,
ker vas Bog ljubi,
he sends you to a community.
Vas pošilja v skupnost.
Because when you experience in life disillusionment with yourself,
ker ko v življenju doživite razočaranje nad samim sabo,
with others,
nad drugimi ljudmi,
you have the community who puts the arms around
you. Imate skupnost, ki vas objame,
and says we are in it together.
In reče, mi smo v tem skupaj.
Otherwise, you would convert the whole world to your model of Christianity.
V nasprotnem primeru bi želeli spreobrniti ves svet v svoj model krščanstva.
And that's why John ends.
In zato Janez zaključuje
with three stories.
S temi tremi zgodbami.
The greatest proof of Christ's resurrection.
Največji dokaz za Kristusovo vstajenje.
What kind of community you and I are.
Je vrsta skupnosti, kakršna vi in mi smo.
And that's why the end of this gospel.
In zato zaključuje evangelij tako.
Imagine.
Zamislite si, predstavljajte si.
If people in Slovenia knew.
Če bi ljudje v Sloveniji vedeli.
If you go to Ljubljana.
Če greste v Ljubljano.
To that church of Seventh-day Adventist.
To adventistično cerkvo.
You will find people.
Boste tam našli ljudi.
Who can ask questions.
where you can ask questions.
Kjer lahko postavljate vprašanja.
They will accept you even if you fail.
Kjer vas bodo sprejeli tudi če padete.
They are true followers of Jesus.
To so resnični Jezusovi sledilci.
Don't tell me that people are not interested.
Ne recite mi, da ljudi to ne bi zanimalo.
Don't tell me that chasing the holy euro could be more important.
Ne boste mi prepričali, da bi tekanje za svetim evrom bilo pomembnejše od tega doživeti.
Revelation 14:12.
Razodetje 14:12.
God says, one day he will have a community like that on this planet.
Bog pravi, imel bom nekega dne skupnost, kot je ta na zemlji.
He says, here they are, I am proud of them.
Tu so, na njih sem ponosen.
Imagine.
Zamislite si.
When Jesus says to the disciples, what have you been talking about on the way?
Ko Jezus reče učencem, o čem ste se pogovarjali na poti?
And everybody got quiet.
In so vsi utihni.
Because they discussed who is the greatest boss here.
Ker so debatirali o tem, kdo je šef.
How Jesus must be proud of them.
Kako Jezus mora biti ponosen na njih.
And they say to Peter, we are in it together.
Ko reče Petru, Peter, skupaj smo v tem.
We are holding together.
Skupaj držimo.
God will have people like that.
Bog bo imel ljudi, kot so ti.
The only question is, do you and I want to be part of that?
Edino vprašanje, ali vi in ja želimo biti del te skupnosti.
And the last sentence?
In zadnji stavek?
And if it's not like that on 12th of March?
In če ni tako, to je 12. marca?
Let's change it.
Potem spremenimo nekaj. Imagine. Zamislite si.
That's the type of community you and I can be.
To je vrsta skupnosti, kakršna vi in jaz lahko postanemo.
That's the church we are supposed to be.
To je cerkev, kakršna bi naj bili.
And if we are not it,
in če to nismo,
we are not going to give up, we are going to change.
Ne bomo odnehali, ampak bomo to spremenili. Amen.
Amen.
Verjamem, da